All right, guys, I'm just making this real quick because obviously there's something wrong with me. I have some sickness. I can't stop doing it. But apparently there's something, and you guys know I don't know anything, but apparently there's something that where a dog has to pick up a dime. I mean, a quarter. And I only just recently heard of it because, oh yeah, Jill, I don't know if you know about this. It's got to be fairly old, though. Who would waste time? Since that's who. I think it's probably from a long time ago. Anyway, my friend Tim's a movie dog trainer, and he's a great trainer. He's the one that told me. But I had seen it before. I had seen other people doing it, getting dogs to pick up a quarter. I just wasn't sure why they were doing it. So then apparently that's the standard. If the dog will pick up a quarter, then you know you've... But then I said, well, you should there should never be a status quo in dog training. So if it can pick up a quarter, we have to break through that and make it pick up a dime. And then if there's something smaller than a U.S. dime, we have to go from there. Unfortunately, the only problem is Shoebottom isn't here. She will pick up a dime, just maybe not when I want her to. Hang on, let me do my psychic recall. So what I've got, this is what I've got. I've got a, from what I can tell, a vacuum token. A nickel. This is all U.S. money. Hi, JC. These are more of my ridiculous, if you said, when do these things come in handy? Oh, cocktail parties. Cocktail parties. These people are three sheets to the wind. Anything's going to entertain them. So with her, all I have to do is drop something. Remember Shoebottom, I said, not the squirrel. I promise she's going to do it. As soon as the squirrel leaves, hang on. All right, psychic recall. We'll start out with something bigger. I will tell you, she's got a little bit of an advantage. I don't know if you know what a manatee is, JC. When you come down, I'm gonna take you to see the manatees. They have this certain kind of mouth. All right, here we go. So I'm just, there's the dime. I gotta really concentrate though. She doesn't see the purpose of all this. So anyway, no more useless drivel. JC's like, I don't wanna learn how to do this. But I think if you, I honestly think, and I got a penny too. I think it was easier for her to pick up the dime, but it's just the way her mouth is. Let me see if I just accidentally drop it. But I have to tell you, she doesn't hear it fall. Okay, so now I can just, let me try looking at it. Because she can spot the tiniest thing on the ground. I'm going to tell you right now, she'll look around. All right, this is actually a U.S. penny, but I gotta tell you, it sounds like plastic, doesn't it? It doesn't sound like metal. All right, hang on. Sure, it's all slimy and gross now, but anyway, you guys. So, you know, that's what I really wanted to say, though, and that's what I want you to think of, JC. And, you know, Courtney had a little thing the other day. You know, if you don't change, you can't get better. Because if you said, I look at your videos from 2 years ago, you haven't changed at all. I look at those videos and say, oh, my God, thank God I changed. You know, so if the industry standard was a quarter, well, now it's a dime. And then whatever's smaller than a dime. Oh, here. It retrieves the actual head of a pin. How does that sound, JC? Somebody shared my video, so I don't want you guys to try this out. For them to have an accidental reflex and swallow it. I got Crash doing it too. Hang on, let me see if I can get her to do it for you guys. And I want you to know, I need a big round of applause for Shoebottom, because that was really cutting into her squirrel and bug chasing time to have to be bothered to pick up, you know, stuff that she's got to be saying. Good God, you dropped it picking up your belt. JC, I want you to know, JC, one of your projects when you're going to be here is babysitting Crash all day. Stopping things like that from happening. You said, why'd you put her on the leash so she doesn't run away? But she'll pick up the tiniest thing too. Well, so much for not running away. All right, hang on. Let me get her back real quick. Showing her. I think, you know, the wind gets her. I told you that one time when it rained, she did kind of forget. I could see where that would be hard for her to understand. So look, I think I gotta show her the stuff. Oh, Crash. Alright, Psychic Grace. Thanks to getting her. Let me see if I can get her back with Psychic. Because you said, what has she been doing since the Easter egg hunt? She's been in there bugging the crap out of me. All right, so she's got to kind of know. She's got to kind of know it, Phil. And for you guys at home that don't know, she's blind and deaf. So if it kind of touches her foot, hang on. If it kind of touches her when it falls. Oh, you broke. All right, that was only a nickel, though. I don't want you getting too excited, JC, if you're still there. That was only a nickel. All right, let me see if I can. You know, she's got to know. And because she's blind and deaf, she probably doesn't know why I've got the leash on her. All right, let me just kind of. There. All right, so let's see how she. Let's see if she knows her money. All right, that's the gas station token. Whoops. None of that was the nickel. Okay, I'll pay her anyway. She doesn't know I dropped it. Oh, I'm smart, though. I'm keeping her on the leash. That's going to be your job, JC. I can maybe put her up here. Yeah, no, she knows about stuff falling on the ground. It's just hard for me. It's hard for me to figure out how to help her know that it dropped without touching her. She gets overly excited. I can try just looking. All right, watch. If it kind of touches her foot. My boy, here comes Shoebottom. Okay, so she felt it. She felt it kind of touch her foot. Not the leash, Crash. Okay, I think she felt it. Crash, you gotta get the dime or it just doesn't count. Here. Okay, you know what? You know how I can do it? Because on this platform, I think she'll feel it. I think she'll feel it drop if I drop it from high enough. I think she'll feel the vibration. And that was something else I thought of. If you said, what could you use? All right, watch. What could you use if you didn't have... Okay, there we go. What could you use... that was the penny. What could you use if you didn't have the pager to send him off the platform? I made it like something, Phil. Yeah, she ran off. She might find that Easter egg from earlier. But I honestly think, Mike, this is what I thought of. If they made the climb vibrate, I think that that would work. I really do. I think it would work. Because I think you could use it. All right, there's the dime. The leash crash. I think you could use it. I think you could use it two ways. I think you could vibrate the platform as a way to get the dog to go over there because it would hear it. So it would be a sound, but it would still be a vibration. Let me see if I can get Shoe Bottom to get it. I'll tell you what Shoe Bottom's advantage is, her mouth. Oh, she'll do it if she thinks that one's coming. Sucks it up with her tongue. Oh, Crash, you're awful. Is it easier on the ground? Apparently it's easier on the ground. Ah! I actually think the dime is easier to... Put it in Mama's hand. I thought she swallowed it. I was just about to say, that was the worst idea ever. Get the idea. Crash can do it if she just would come over. Crash is on some kind of rampage today. But anyway, guys, that was my demo, and I would be better off to probably do it in the house because I don't. He said what? But there's no squirrels and everything in there. But that was my latest idea I came up with, and let me know if you guys think that would be a good idea. You know, the dog would be away from the platform. You could make the platform vibrate. They would run over there, and you could make it stop vibrating as soon as they got on there. And then you could do the reverse thing, too. If you wanted to send them off there, just do like I do the pager. They'd be ready to go. The second they felt the vibration, they would jump off of there. I doubt that's going to ever get invented, but I just was thinking about it, you know, that would be a good idea. So, anyway, you guys, I'll be right back.